We have had Bhairava Puja in Belgium. And now I thought today let us have Mahakali Puja. Because yesterday's experience, last night's experience, was the work of Mahakali. She has a double role all the time. She is at two extremes. On one side, she is full of joy, giver of joy, feels very happy when she sees her disciple are joyous. Joy is her own quality, is her energy. And yesterday, you must have been amazed to see so many middle-aged ladies of France smiling and laughing. I had never seen them smiling. It's very surprising how they were so joyous and so very happy. And this is the energy of Mahakali that gives you all that joy after realization. And the joy you enjoy among yourselves, all these are the qualities of Mahakali. And when they will read out the names of Mahakali, you will know how her powers manifest in Sahaja Yoga and how it has helped you all to get drenched into the ocean of joy. To begin with, I have to tell you one thing, that Mahakali Puja, when you are doing, you have to feel the joy within yourself and joy from other sadhus. If you cannot feel that, that means you are not at home. And there's some problem, maybe with your parents, maybe with your children, maybe with family, with your country, whatever it is, but there's some sort of a conditioning which is working out that doesn't give you that joy. And to grow into Sahaja Yoga is very important, which I think people don't understand, even if they live in ashrams. They don't understand one thing, that you have to be collective. If you are not collective, then you are thrown out gradually. Now this Mahakali power has got seven strings, you can say this. And these strings are there to throw you out into collective subconscious areas. Like as in the sitar you have seen for the resonance, there are other strings also. So once you start getting out of the collectivity, it is the Mahakali herself picks you out and starts throwing you out slowly, slowly to the subconscious area. And where you just disappear. And all kinds of problems start then. I've seen this happening in every country, that people do not attend the collective meditation. For France, I have the same report. And I think the people who do not grow will be thrown out. Sahaja Yoga, as you know, has a double action, as the Mahakali has a double action. She is extremely loving, full of joy, full of happiness, and she's the one who is extremely cruel, wrathful. She's the one who is the slayer of all the demons and the evil, and those people who try to do evil. So once you are thrown out into the left side, then you can imagine, you can develop any kind of left side diseases to begin with. Muladhara diseases are the worst. you develop diseases like mellitus, this, you must have heard of the disabilities caused by the muscles getting degenerated. All muscular degeneration comes from this problem. So at any cost, that must be avoided. But if you are not in the collective, if you do not understand the collective, and if you are out of the collective, you will be surprised that negative forces will join together and they'll pull you out. So this is one of the things that happens. So be very careful that don't avoid the collective programs. Another problem about Mahakali is that she's the one who gives you the feeling for your wife, for your husband. She is the one. Now there also, the same problem. If both of them are all right, she is all right. But if she finds any one of them going astray, she'll throw that person out and out and out. And the another person, if that person is attached with that person also, will be thrown out. So this business of falling in love, this nonsense that we have here, that you fall in love, but the word is all right because you fall really in love. There's a real falling happens. So what happens when you start falling in love? There's a kind of a maya of this Mahakali. And you just get infatuated, your ego get pampered or something like that, or you have certain ideas of a wife or something, and then you think, oh, that's the one for me. So in these cases only two things can happen. Either you can be lost completely because of your wife or your husband whom you adore and admire, and you're finished, I mean your personality is finished. Or else, another thing which is even more serious is that will completely break forever and hate each other. That's why they say that there's a love and hate relationship. How can love be hate? But it becomes, because of this quality of the goddess, that she is on one side is extremely loving, extremely kind, extremely soft. She goes up to a point. And then she throws you on the other side. And that is why in these countries where people always fall in love, you see, they don't marry otherwise, unless and until they have fallen in love. In that they cross all the maryadas also. In falling in love they'll marry somebody who's already married, or who's, they'll carry on with somebody who is not yet divorced, or also they will have marriages among themselves in the same household or something. All kinds of things they do. An old woman marries a young man, or an young old man marries a young girl, like that, all nonsensical things without any maryadas. And they do not stick together. They have no maryadas. So marriage is to create a maryada. Maryada of your behavior. And this is the maryada which if you do not keep, then this Mahakali gets into it. So first of all, one has to be collective. The ones who are not collective, who do not attend every time a collective program, you might give suggestions that you would like to come for such and such thing. For example, I have already explained that you shouldn't talk. There are so many tapes which they have never heard. Please let them listen to my tape, then go into meditation, and then do the arti and finish it off. Because these tapes are to be heard again and again. Now those who get any questions out of those tapes can next time discuss it before starting the tapes. That's a very good thing and that works. In India nobody speaks. They just put my tapes on, or show my video. After that, they just have meditation and aarti. Finished. After that, nobody talks. But before starting it, they do it is to talk to each other and discuss the problems or discuss anything that they felt about the previous program. Because you have not come here to marry someone or to fall in love into something. You have not come here to get after some woman because she is your wife or some man because he is your husband. You have had so many husbands and wives in previous lives. But you have come here for your ascent. And if you have come for your ascent, you have to keep a watch. How is your mind working? Supposing I say that you should have good married life. Of course I do say you should have good married life. But not at the cost of losing your ascent. It has happened with people. We have lost a complete, I should say, a city like that. Such stupidity comes up over people. So be careful not to get lost. You have not come here to have only a happy married life, but happy married life is just one step. But if that step is taking you away from the real path of your ascent, it's better to be careful. Also, we must understand the innocence means purity, purity of thought. As I explained yesterday, I hope you understood the meaning of purity. Purity is to be understood much more by Europeans. Very important. Especially French. Because the whole society is suffering. Society can only be pure if the family life is pure. Not only that, but your relations with each other are pure. Like I was told that somebody fell in love in Ganpatipule. I mean, you go for a pilgrimage. It's like you have to go to buy a sari and you end up with a shaving stick. Is that stupid? You are coming to Ganpatipule for what? You are coming there for your ascent. It's a pilgrimage. But in the pilgrimage I have never heard anybody falls in love with each other and goes to marriage. So this bhoot of falling in love must be given up in Sahaja Yoga. That is one of the biggest loads. And now one must understand that purity means chastity. Innocence means chastity. Not only physical, also mental chastity. You have to have mental chastity. If you don't have mental chastity, you cannot ascend. Actually, in the West, it is more mental than physical. It's a fact. And that's why their brains have gone off. And they are becoming just like, I think, potatoes now, I think. Because if you go on mentally, imagining and playing around and working it out this way, it's going to be absolutely dangerous because it's all imagination. It has nothing to do with reality. The more you get into this kind of a nonsense, the more you become away from reality. That never means you should be dry. It never means you should be negligent of your responsibility. It does not mean. As I said, the sap माझ्या पर्समध्ये कधी राधी बट्टी येते काढ. As I have said, that the sap in the tree rises, all right? Then it purifies, it nourishes, every part of the plant separately in a different way. Like, it's a mother, so mother. Father is a father. Sister is a sister. Brother is a sister. Brother is a brother. The brother-sister relations cannot become husband-wife relations. How can it be? Now, what happens really is that such a confusion in the mind, and it has created tremendous problems for us. Then the sap nourishes all these things and comes back. It doesn't get attached to something. Oh, she's my wife. So the first priority is my wife. Because I've said, of course, family life has to be all right. You must look after your family life. But that doesn't mean that you make everything suffer. That doesn't mean that your ascent should be finished. It cannot mean that. You're not like ordinary people. You're saints. And for the saints, the main thing is their ascent. Not their family life, not their material possessions, nothing, nor their children, but their ascent. Once they ascend, everything will ascend with it. Now the understanding of chastity should be there. It can come to you very easily. If you ascend, it's such a vicious circle. It is such a vicious circle. Now, first of all, you get your realization, all right? Now, you must know that Kundalini itself is the Mahakali Shakti. Because she is the primordial. Mahakali Shakti is the primordial Shakti within us. And it's the Kundalini is the Mahakali Shakti. And she remains as a virgin within you. And she is purity. She has a power to purify. All that happens when you get your realization. She starts manifesting her all beautiful aspects in you. Now the one who is sitting there is Sri Ganesh. Now people don't understand what is innocence. Sri Ganesha is sitting there and he is the one who presides over Muladhara, even over his mother, because he's like a god. And he is the one who tells whether she can ascend or not, unless and until he gives permission. She cannot ascend. So Sri Ganesha gives the ascending sort of a okay, all right, you can rise. And he stops all his work. You have seen me sitting for hours together. I don't have to go even to the bathroom or anywhere because Ganesha stops all his work. He's only worried now about the ascent. And on every chakra, he checks your purity. And then accordingly the Kundalini tries to purify. But when it reaches the mental level, mental level has all these funny ideas of romance, this nonsense, that nonsense. I was surprised the other day, there was a girl who was having a trouble with her husband of expressing her love to her husband after marriage. Before marriage she was all right. So I told her, read some book where they have described the romance between husband and wife. So she said, there is no book I have known. And I asked one professor to find out. He said, there's no such book. In Sahaja Yoga, the romance starts after the marriage. But also with maryadas, not at the cost of Sahaja Yoga, not at the cost of your ascent. So all these ideas people have in the West, I know you are so much conditioned about it. So we say now, let us see, this is Samayachara, after all, we have to give all the benefit to them. Now we select people, we do everything. It's all the work of Mahakali, because you have to work on the vibrations. It's all the work of Mahakali. And after marriages also, some marriages do fail. The reason being, they do not know what is the purpose of their marriages. So the first and foremost thing of Mahakali is that she is purity. Absolute purity. And that purity, if we cannot imbibe within us, we cannot be Sahajyogis. Now this mind is so much conditioned, I know. Our children would be much better off than ourselves. But they won't have these conditionings as we have had. And so many problems can be just avoided if we really become pure people. I see in the other society in which I move, nobody seems to be safe. Somebody's wife is running with somebody's husband, somebody's daughter is running with somebody's father, somebody's running, a boy running with somebody's mother. Next day you find somebody else standing there as husband, wife. Or sometimes it's so funny that you can't believe it, how can it be? And everybody is in danger. A man goes to the house, he finds his wife run away with another man. Or a man goes for his work, he's run away with another woman. So she's the one, she gives you sthiti, the state. Sthiti means consolidation. Without your proper consolidation into your purity, not into your romantic life, you cannot rise. Like when we make the aeroplane, first we have to consolidate it, fix it up properly, work it out, so that when it goes in the air, all its parts do not fly away with the passengers. In the same way, when we are ascending, Sri Ganesha does that. He just stops the action of excretion completely and the ascent starts. They are doing their work all right, despite the fact they have been insulted, they have been neglected, we have misbehaved, whatever we might have done. They are doing their jobs all right. You can see so many people getting realization. But what are we doing about it? We cannot be even collective. We cannot attend collective things. And look at them, how generous they are. They are extremely collective. They are extremely collective. To such an extent, somebody supposing worships Sri Krishna, his heart will catch. Why? Because you must also worship Shiva. They are so collective and so much connected with me. So they are all collective in the same way you are also devas, you also should be collective. As soon as you become collective, all these nonsensical things will drop out. All these ideas will drop out. You do not become collective because you have not dropped out all these things, or else you are afraid of dropping them out. So let us know what is our purpose. Our purpose is to ascend. And what is the Mahakali power is doing for us? She is giving you your ascent through Kundalini. She is purifying. She is giving you all the powers. She is protecting you all the time. She is giving you joy. But what are we doing for her? Her only desire is that my children should be saintly, that they should have beautiful qualities of a saint, that he doesn't fall at every woman, fall at every man. He's not so cheap, you see. And mentally especially. I mean, if the Sahasrara is spoiled, how can Sahaja work out? The whole play is of the Sahasrara. And that purity should manifest. Through you we are going to change the world. Through no one else. The Sahaja Yogis who are going to change the world. Now look at the generosity. Even my body is so generous. Yesterday, one lady came, I think she had a very bad liver. She came downstairs and my liver started pumping vibrations. Terrible. She had a very bad liver though. She had taken drugs. I mean, she had taken drugs and all that suffering was done to me by this liver of mine. You didn't think that, poor mother, she's come all the way after suffering, so started just pumping for that woman. So generous it is. And they are so generous themselves, the way they bestow blessings on you. How they are hard working, how they are running about. What are we giving them? They give us joy. They look after us. They look after our children. They look after everything. They manage everything. Now what are we doing for them? Also, I've heard that people don't help when they have to postering, they have to do. Very few people come up. This is being ungrateful. Very ungrateful to those. All the deities are present when you are having those collective programs. And surprisingly, the old Sahaja Yogis are more difficult than the new ones. I mean, this is just surprising. I mean, are they becoming now out of date or something? Christ has said, first will be the last. I hope that's not going to happen. Sort of a confidence they develop. Oh, we are old Sahaja Yogis. We have had horrible results in London of this consciousness that we are old, we'll do whatever we like. We may attend the collective or not. A kind of an ego. Please be careful. Christ has clearly said, first will be the last. And I have seen so many of them just getting out like that. Even I don't know how they get out. In such stupid ways that unimaginable for anyone. Like one gentleman in Italy was an old Sahaja Yogi, just got up and said, I am Mahamataji. Everybody started looking at him. What do you mean? I am Mahamataji. And I'm going to do all this myself. So they said, all right, so we are going out of ashram. No, I can't manage the ashram, I'm getting out. And he went and stayed with someone, that lady, who heard against me and got cancer and died. In the collectivity, supposing you have one problem, another one has some problem, it just works out, balances. As one finger is cut out, it is useless then. Or a nail which is taken out is useless. It dies. So, that is how we are organizing our spiritual death and ultimately I don't know what else. And then they come back, that mother, I have got now this trouble, so I have come back, I was out of Sahaja Yoga for 3 years. I say, what do you mean out of Sahaja Yoga? I didn't attend any collective program. I'm thinking of the collectivity of the whole world. That's my vision. And if Sahaja Yogis cannot be collective, who is going to be collective? Who is going to fulfill my vision? So all of you, those who call themselves Sahaja Yogis, must attend the program. And the second thing is that there was a little problem of generosity of people. Of course, that also is a character of Mahalakshmi. She's very generous. And when you are generous in giving vibrations and looking after people, this and that, then Mahalakshmi's principle works out. But Mahalakshmi doesn't give money to people who are miserly, will never give. They may have money in the bank, but they can never enjoy. So if there is need, people have to give money to Sahaja. I have been supplying a lot of money, as you know, from the very beginning. Those who are early Sahaja Yogis will know how much I have been able to pay. But now we are growing, and everybody should know that we have to pay. After all, this is our responsibility. Where are we going to spend our money? In what? I mean, my family feels that whatever money I am spending for Sahaja Yoga is the best. They get punyas. It's the best for them. Only with punyas you get more wealth, health and prosperity. If you do not have punyas, you cannot get it. It will come and go away. It will disappear into thin air. So I was surprised that people are not generous. We have to know that we are so much better off people than many others. Like the Eastern Bloc people are not so good in money matters just now. I'm not saying that we have to help them, but we have to think, can we send something for them as presents? Can we do something for them? The matter has the value, which is again Mahakali's power. It's the power of Mahakali that the matter carries the love, expresses. So many times I've seen how very sweetly they gave me something. I really don't take anything and I don't need anything. But certain things, it shows such concern, such understanding, such love. How will you express your love to those people who are so far away? You just try. Try to give. Try to give for Sahaja Yogas. And you'll be amazed how it will work out. For collectivity, we have to know that sea for Bhairavanath and Sri Hanumana and Sri Ganesha. These three principles that work within us. All of them have parallel work to do, parallel. They do not interfere for each other. But if it comes to help, they'll go all out. There's no quarrel. No quarrel between the two. No. If Hanumana needs Bhairava, he's there. If Bhairava needs Hanumana, he's there. All out. So this collectivity comes only by understanding one thing. What a great work we are doing today. People are not conscious of that. They take it just by the way. In the war, you have seen how people fight. Even if they have the fear of dying. Formerly, nobody was paid also in the military. But they went and fought. Maybe for their country, for anything. And they used to join together to fight. They allowed themselves to be killed. They helped each other. They did this. All these qualities are there when we want to hate someone. But when we want to love someone, why shouldn't we have those qualities emerging out of us? These are the qualities of Mahakali. Because she is the expert of war affairs. She is the one who makes people war. And she is the one who makes them fight. Because it's the desire. They have nothing there, just the desire to do something. And then they join together and then the Mahasaraswati helps them to act. But first the desire is so strong. Now the desire has to be very, very strong within us that we have to be for the emancipation of the whole world. We are the people. We are the special people. We are in the foundation. Nothing is more important than our own personality being completely dedicated for surgery. This desire has to be extremely strong and very pure. Those actually desire it, actually, they get their realization like that. They reach their depth like that. And they enjoy doing work of surgery. All the time they enjoy it. For them, nothing is more important. As we say, there's a saying that when you get the water of Ganges to drink, why should you take water from dirty rivers? So the whole attention is that side. All the joy you get out of this romance and this love and this and that becomes zero before it. Because it's nirananda, only joy. In the marriage, you see wife says like this, says that, all this is so conditioning. Any joy. You have different joys on different centers. They are all given by Mahakali. But the greatest of all you have got after realization is the Nirananda. That state you must reach, to Nirananda state. If you are in that state of Nirananda, then all other these pleasures and joys are zero. I mean, so many people who told me they were very fond of cricket in India. They said, Mother, we don't see nowadays cricket. I said, why? Because the enjoyment is not there now. It's sort of, that enjoyment is lost. Otherwise, Indians are mad after cricket. See, even in the forest, if you go, they'll be listening to the cricket. It's a game played by English, who are not so much interested, but Indians are. And now, if you ask them, they say, no, we're not interested. So many people who used to read 7-8 newspapers said, we never read newspapers, never good news finished. And still they are managing. Because the whole focus of your attention is now on Sahaja Yoga, because you only enjoy Sahaja Yoga. You like to meet Sahaja Yogis, you have to be with Sahaja Yogis. We had a puja in England. It was raining and quite a vibrant puja of Sri Ganesha. But nobody was bothered. It started pouring down through the pandal they had put up. Nobody was bothered. All right, water has come, let the water pass this way, we'll sit that side. Everybody adjusted, because first thing was to enjoy. They didn't want to give up enjoyment at any cost. And it continued the whole night. One was worried because somebody has threatened that the police will come. I made the police sleep also, and the man who was to report also was sleeping. So the whole night we enjoyed ourselves. Now this enjoyment cannot come to you if you do not have purity of your mind. Nirananda. You can get other anands of other things, other chakras, but bring the purity. Just by developing thoughtless awareness and looking at things without thinking. For that you have to be collective. If you are collective, I am there. Wherever you are collective, wherever you gather, I am there. And nothing gives me greater pleasure to hear that all of you are attending this program. You'll be amazed that in Australia we have so many centers in every city, but they all attend the programs of collectivity. Because they know collectivity is the ocean of nourishment. This is the simplest thing we have to do. But the bhoots are much more collective. Much more collective. Bhoots can go to such a length of fraternity that you'll be amazed. There was a lady in France only. She was an old lady, and her daughter was in Sahaja Yoga. She had become absolutely mad, so she put her in the absolutely bhootish. So she put her in an elderly home. In the elderly home, she only knew how to go to church on Sundays. She would dress up and go to church. That's the only sensible thing she used to do. So, she put her in the thing. And there was a church. And she told me this, her daughter told me that it is very amazing that all of them get up in the morning, dress up well and go to church. And inside the church there are graves of people who have died out of those, half mad or full mad elderly people. Otherwise they did not know even how to wear their dresses. They didn't know how to eat their food. They didn't know anything. But when it came to going to church, to that bhootish place where all the bhoots were there, they all would get up in the morning, dress up properly, and go to the church, sit down, sing hymns and come back, as if like possessions. Such a fraternity of bhoots there is. As soon as one bhoot comes in, one bhoot came now recently from Australia. Now he is gathering all the bhoots around here. He went to Pune, there he gathered all the bhoots, immediately. Then he came here, now he is gathering those bhoots. People are getting friendly with him. Exactly who are bhoots, you can make it out by just seeing a bhoot sitting there and who is sitting next to that person. They are so attracted like a magnet. Well, the magnet is the quality of Mahakali. Bhoots know me better than anybody else can know, because they know my past. They are in the past. And they know who has got bhoots and how they attract each other. And how they act on a bhootish person. That is why the positive collectivity has to be there. But when it comes to positivity, they do not get collective. All those who do not get collective will gradually go into the fraternity of bhoots. Because today we are dealing about Mahakali. She is the one who knows everything about these bhootish things. She is in charge, I mean. She is the lord of all these bhoots. And she knows, and she looks after them and she manages them. But when Sahajagis want to go into that realm, what has she to do? She has locked them up on one side. But Sahajagis want to go there, just enter through back doors into that area. What can you do? Of course she protects. She doesn't want anyone to go there. She's just kept them out and told the bhoots not to come this side. But Sahajagis only go there. That's being reported. Under these circumstances, Sahajoga has gone very far, very much, in so many other countries. In France, you have seen yesterday how this Ananda Shakti of the mother acted on people. It was wonderful to see that. Everybody came to me and they were full of smiles. I've never seen any French woman of that age smiling, never, no question. Even if you tickle them, even if you certify that this is a joke, they will not smile like that. I've never seen their teeth. Yesterday the whole face was lit up. So many of them. Something so miraculous it was. This Anandini Shakti of Mahakali was acting so beautifully yesterday. And you are the people who will now guide or misguide them. If you become, all of you become higher personalities, if you become collective, all of you, and if you become generous, and if you become absolutely pure, they will say, now look at these people, how beautiful they look. You already look very beautiful. Your face is shine, but it will all disappear. And the effects of disappearance are not very simple. So be careful. I, of course, bless you with all the qualities of Bhairava, as he is the greatest disciple of Mahakali. And he is the one who is running up and down morning till evening every time, especially in the night. He is working so very hard, killing those horrible rakshasas, these, that, and achieving such results. We have to join him, all of us, and work it out. May God bless you.